This video is sponsored by TCL CSOT. Display tech is evolving fast. From big screens, to small ones, ones we use at home, and some while we're on the go. With so much changing, it may seem like it's difficult to find the next big thing. But luckily, I've got a secret. Welcome to a Display Nerd's Paradise, otherwise known as Display Week 2025. I'm here in San Jose, checking out the latest from TCL CSOT. This is the B2B division of the TCL that we know and love, and they're the ones responsible for a lot of the cutting edge display tech we've got in devices all around the world. They've got a lot of new stuff they've been cooking up for 2025. I got a little peek inside, and it's impressive. They're taking things up a couple of notches, or I guess in this case, a couple of nits, in the wild world of displays. Let's go inside and let me show you what's new. Okay, so as we pixel peep our way around the booth here, there's obviously a whole lot of display tech to see, including many world firsts.
Like the world's smallest silicon micro LED display,
the world's first ultra wide color gamut OLED MB display, and the world's narrowest splicing dual curve display coming to a car near you soon. Now, obviously these displays are innovative and interesting in their own right, but also they have sort of a common thread between them. They're part of the same family, or in this case, the Apex innovative platform, which means they share a couple of the same core design principles. They're energy efficient and eco-friendly. They're using some really awesome cutting edge technology, and they're also built with this human-centered design. Basically, they're built for where we actually use our screens these days, whether that's sitting at home on the couch, if that's at work, sort of using a big display on our desks, or maybe more than ever these days, we're using our displays for media, maps, and navigation in our cars. And one of the best examples of this is a new lineup of inkjet printing OLED displays, or IJP OLED for short. Now, this isn't your typical OLED. TCL CSOT has been developing this tech for over a decade now, and here at the show floor, they're showing how this IJP OLED can power basically everything from smartphones, tablets, laptops, TVs, you name it, it can probably use IJP OLED. And what makes IJP OLED so special is really how it's made. Like the name suggests, it's kind of like printing the pixels directly on the panel itself, with sort of still giving you the inky blacks and the rich colors that you'd, you know, obviously expect from OLED screens. And when it's done at the scale that TCL CSOT is doing, it means that these panels are more eco-friendly and also more cost-effective, which is just a win-win-win all around for everyone. So this IGP OLED stuff is super impressive, but what do you actually need to know? What's really changing here, and why exactly is this so innovative? These are the questions that I had, and luckily I got to go right to the man himself. I got to chat with the CEO of TCL CSOT, Jun Zhao. I actually got a bit of an exclusive sort of tour of the booth to check out these different products, and got to hear why this technology is so special.
IGP OLED isn't just a new technology. It's a redefinition of what's possible in display technology. 6.5-inch mobile panel to a 65 HK TV. This evolution demonstrating not just the technical versatility, but unmatched scalability across product segments.
And one of the best examples I can show is this right here. Let's start big with a 65-inch IJP OLED TV that packs all the bells and whistles you would want as the centerpiece of your living room. It's packing an 8K resolution, 120 hertz refresh rate, and up to 800 nits of brightness. And one of the nice benefits of this IJP OLED TV is it's gonna fix a lot of those common issues you might have seen when you're sort of looking at a TV from not the sweet spot, so weird color shifting or reduced brightness. This really does a good job at eliminating those, so next time you've got a family member or some friends coming over for a movie night, no one's gonna complain about having that bad spot in the living room. But IJP is just one part of the Apex platform. There's some other innovations here to check out, including some pretty big advancements in the micro LED and mini LED space, with some pretty cool demos behind me that take things super small and also crazy big. Let's start small, like really small. This is the world's smallest silicon micro LED display, measuring just a whopping 0.05 inches. This is like perfect for the next generation of smart glasses, AR, VR contraptions, with an insane 50-80 pixels per inch and brightness of over 4 million nits. I'm gonna do a little test here right on the show floor. I can confirm it is super lightweight, obviously very portable, and also really impressively bright as well, as we hear so much these days about the next generation of wearables and AR glasses and mixed reality. We need some high-end, really, you know, legible displays to sort of make that magic happen, which is exactly what this is. And this is kind of a little taste of the future, and I can't wait to replace these with something more like this. Or we can flip the script and go big, really big. This is a 219 inch MLED display. Or check this out. This is a transparent micro LED display where it looks like the text in the image is just sort of like floating there. Could be really cool in like a museum or, I don't know, restaurant. Just sort of cool to see how this tech could be used in the real world. Speaking of real world, why not upgrade the interior of our cars with something like this? It's the world's narrowest splicing dual curve display, spanning 23.6 inches. This thing is made to be in the next generation of vehicles. Between MLED technology advancements, IGP OLED, big screens, small screens, there's a whole lot going on, but TCL CSOT says this is just the beginning.
TCL CSOT isn't following the trends. We are defining the future of display. With our IGP OLED program, we moved beyond lab innovation to commercial viability at scale. Micro LED is beginning to show real promise in some scenarios. Our earlier indicators of where this technology can go, and we are optimistic about its long-term potential.
Now, as fun as it was to sort of geek out and pixel peep around the booth, my honest takeaway here is that it's amazing to see a company not only solving real-world problems, but also building the next generation of displays. I know I'm not the only one that is super excited for the not too distant future of AR glasses that don't look like a crazy VR headset, or some amazing new TV for my living room, or a crazy new display for my car. All of that is only going to happen if a company is willing to invest in the R&D and work out the kinks and solve these problems and push the boundaries of display technology, which is exactly what TCL CSOT is doing, and they're doing it right here, right now. So it was cool to get a front row seat and take a look at all that new stuff. Hope you guys enjoyed. A big thanks again to them for sponsoring this video. A big thanks to you guys for watching. Thank you so much. I'm Robert Rosenfeld. We'll see you guys next time.